Hey folks, welcome back to Let's Play Grand Theft Auto San Andreas on Mysterious JG. I think I've gotten confused with my video count. I think I might have, starting a new little session here, I think I might have ended the last session thinking I'd finished a week's worth of videos for those watching as they go up. I don't know what the hell's going on. Also, we may have been standing around for a while because I loaded the game and then had to walk out of the room and do something and came back, and CJ may have been standing around doing nothing for an unusual length of time, but anyway, yeah, he is doing a little stretch, like he's been chilling out for a minute. Okay, you guys aren't in a panic because of me. Something else has happened. Okay, I am going around dressed like this with an eye patch and carrying a combat shotgun. But that doesn't appear to be the cause of the confusion. Boy, I tell you, those horseshoes are the toughest one to get, and I'm pretty sure I never got them before. I don't remember having ever collected them as part of just playing on the PS2 back in the day. But man, these weapon drops. Shit.
Hey, nice clothes.
My clothes, thanks. I'm real vain.
I'm not sure if that was a positive or negative response. That might have been a sarcastic response. Oh, you know what? I think I am in the wrong place to continue this storyline. That's right. We got to go to Caligula's palace. Okay, so at the end of the last video, I was kind of thinking out loud about whether we should do the side quest stuff now or later. But I think I'm just going to continue with the main story, and I am playing ahead in all my series, but this one is not an exception. I play a bit ahead because I'm trying to be ready to go, like, you know, have a couple of weekends visiting the family instead of recording, and you know, keep my uploads going. Okay, wow. I was worried for a second I had just crashed my recording software. I was like, no, the PS4 just got really slow for a moment. But yeah, but I'm not going to finish the game before people have a chance to comment. But I am curious as whether people want to see me leave off the casino heist mission until the end or do it as soon as is possible. Because generally in the Grand Theft Auto games, I've been leaving a few things to do after the main story. But in Vice City, there's not that many things that you can wait till after the main story to do. Other than, I guess, the... Did I finish the main story before I did the heist mission in that? I don't even remember. I don't know if I did or not. I guess that's the one that I would want to think about. But yeah, in Grand Theft Auto 3, I remember I had never really known how much stuff you could put off until after the main story was done before. Because I'd done everything really except the main story when I played through on PS2. But then Donald Love's last mission is an even bigger anticlimax when you do that. So let me know. Like, to me, it seems fun to have a little bit of life and adventure for CJ after we finish the main story, because the main story is really just putting a few things right involving his family. So having a little bit left to do other than just his family's fixed and the game ends might be kind of fun. And I don't remember how long the heist missions... I really don't remember how involved it is. Oh, crap. Almost got busted there. That wouldn't have been any good. I don't know why that would be the case, friend. Why would you want to live in Texas? Insulting Texas for no real reason. I spent a little bit of time in Austin, related to a work thing. And Austin seems like a pretty fucking cool city. And my parents spent a little bit of time in San Antonio, and they've told me it's a really cool place to be. But overall, man, when you hear about Texas on the news, I'm sorry. Forgive me if you're from Texas. Just Texas keeps popping up on the news for things like, you know, we're gonna have it like it's illegal not to own an assault rifle, and it's illegal to wear a mask, and if you say the word abortion out loud, you will go to, like, it doesn't sound like a place that I would enjoy at all. But, what would I know? Anyway, Caligula's Casino is a big old building that we can actually go inside of. Kind of curious what all you could do in here. Because I believe this is the same casino that we would be robbing in the story missions. And there's other big casinos like the Clown's Pocket and stuff. We can't actually go inside. They have big exteriors. I don't think you get to go inside those. Although you get them as save points because you get... You eventually buy... You see, this is the other thing. There's none of the horseshoes are inside these big buildings. I would think you'd have hidden stuff in here. Oh, but you know what? I'm being a goof. I just got done talking about how we do a heist mission here. This stuff is probably part of the heist mission, so there's no point in me messing with it now. Anyway, well, there's the music that plays in, the Four Dragons Casino, or Twin Dragons Casino, which is why I thought maybe it wouldn't play here, because it's like the Four Dragon Casino theme. But this whole radio station is a copyright strike madness, so I probably don't want to just be hanging around forever. And we can gamble here, but I'm sure it's exactly the same games that you can play at the Four Dragons, or the two... Twin Dragons. Why do I keep calling it Four Dragons? It's the Twin Dragon Casino. Oh, here we go. Hell and Vader don't go all the way to the top. Intensive care.
Rosie, liven yourself up. Carl's here.
It's nice that they call us Carl. It's more formal.
Hey, there's some top fanny down at that pool pub, Z.
Leave it out, Dimlow. What's
Fanny?
Wrong with you? Well, are you going to tell him or shall I?
Fanny doesn't mean the same thing in British slang, by the way, as it does in American slang, in case you were
spit it out.
Confused on that score.
I threw it all away. Okay, I had the power, the money, the ladies, but I couldn't lay off the blow. So I went into rehab, and everything went to shit, but so what?
So when he I was on out, blow? That's not the Ken Rosenberg I knew from Vice City.
But no one family would trust family to run the casino, so I was put forth as a neutral party. So now I spend
even though you work for Vice City, who has his own family now?
And blame the other one. My only friend is a bird named Tony.
I never fucked anyone over in my life who didn't have it coming to him.
That's a pretty convoluted phrase.
You got to break it down for me real quick.
Okay, okay. The Sindacos are on the warpath, okay?
Just like
something
Tatanka.
Terrible has happened to Johnny. I mean, he's in a shock-induced coma at the hospital across town.
I ain't know nothing about that.
They will take this opportunity to rub him out. Now, if any hit between the families succeeds on my turf, I will get the axe, bullet, machete.
Okay,
whatever.
Okay, relax.
So he's responsible for stopping all mafia activity? Well, kills.
There you go, my love. Things ain't so bad, are they?
Who's guarding my father? Okay, so logic's a bit... Maybe this is how mafia stuff works. I haven't watched all that many mafia movies over the years. I mean, I saw Goodfellas, obviously. I've seen the Godfather trilogy. But if a Jewish lawyer... I don't think the Jewish lawyer part matters, but bear with me, because it has to do with, you know, these Italian families. Okay, they have a non-Italian who's a lawyer... He's been put in place. Actually, the Jewish thing does matter because Godfather 2, casinos, right? Wasn't it like the... Wasn't the guy that, didn't Fredo sell them out to a Jewish family? I don't know. I'm forgetting. But, no, the point is, he's not part of the war, but it's like, okay, the mafia is going to blame you if a hit succeeds on their turf, but... Like, how is... It doesn't make sense. Wouldn't the party that actually did the kill be the one that would get in trouble? I guess they're saying if the family whose member gets killed, while they're going for revenge, they might go for revenge on him too. But I don't understand how he would be held responsible if he hasn't been, by the Italian families, given some kind of power to actually prevent this from happening. Seems like the only reason he's involved is because he's neutral. So if a war breaks out between the families, it's going to break out between the families.
About to try and rescue some guy that's scared half to death.
Yeah.
If he wake up through all this, I'm screwed.
Uh-huh. So CJ's got a good point here. And it's a funny bit of story that I enjoy, the fact that we got to go rescue this guy. But I'm not sure that it makes sense. But I still do appreciate that, the guy that we put into a coma through pure fear, now we got to rescue him. Of course, we could shop at Binko on the way, but no. And the hospital reminds me, we didn't finish dating, what's her name? The woman voiced by China Chow. See, these are normally plot vehicles. They're not plot vehicles, but I always associate, seeing one of these in GTA 3 and thinking, oh, that looks cool, and getting into it, and it's like, oh, damn it, it triggers a non-required clear the checkpoints mission. You need a vehicle to pick up Johnny. Johnny, get you. Now, that might be why this is here. I wonder if they'll let me use a motorcycle. It seems like they shouldn't. Because he would have to be awake and clinging on to the motorcycle. Oh, I guess I can. Oh, used cars. We are all
about
cars.
Hello, sir. Can I help you?
Yeah, I'm here to pick up Mr. Sindaco.
Mr. Sindaco? There must be some mistake.
He's already been killed.
Just picked him up.
Oh, okay. Thank you for your help.
Do you want to know which ambulance or where I was going, or why an ambulance is taking him away from the hospital? Find the ambulance that contains Johnny. Okay, so yeah, we just decide. Okay, thanks for setting up this interesting mission where I gotta chase multiple ambulances. Okay, so I don't remember this mission at all, which means it's probably not that bad. I hope. Honestly, I remember the last, like, two or three missions of the main game, but all the other missions I remember are missions we've already done. So, the entire Lost Ventura stretch of this game, I have almost no recall of. Other than some of the cinematics and plot points, there's no missions in this stretch of game that I really remember clearly. Okay, it's the real deal because what? It's the real deal because the guy inside acted panicky? I guess that's what's going on. Uh-oh. Well, I mean, shoot game. I guess that makes sense, but at the same time, it's treating it like I did something wrong. And now I'm really curious what that place with the cool Chinese statues outside was. Or Asian statues, I don't know if they're Chinese specifically.
San Andreas, gotta love it. Move here for the weather, but they hide the sun under a cloud of pollution.
Okay.
This music is like a
the fact that they freaked out means this one's for real. Because wrong button. I tried to ram it, and it didn't do anything. I am in a motorcycle, after all. All right, so I need to get onto the highway as quickly as possible, because that's, or the main strip, rather. Straight, then left, then right, basically.
Hello, Dusthead, what's on your mind?
You're so lame. You're trapped in a time warp. Nobody understands what the hell you're saying.
Look, shithead, I run through life with a torch in one hand and a sword in the other, and when I play the music the program director tells me to, I don't care whether your hair is green, you love men, or you're missing fingers. Sooner or later, it's logger.
I don't understand what...
Who cares about the listeners anyway?
I guess the joke is, no one understands what you're saying, and then he started saying something nonsensical, so never mind. I was about to explain... I'm explaining the joke. I was like... I understand why he reacts that way to this guy, but never mind.
More music and less me. It's the dust talking.
Okay, so smash it up a bit is what we're supposed to do. I just ran over an Elvis impersonator. I take it I'm not supposed to blow it up. not really all that sure what I'm supposed to do with this damn ambulance. I don't think they're gonna let me just jack it. That sounded dirty in a way I didn't actually intend. Oh, that was a different ambulance came in. Because now it's fleeing again, even though there was an ambulance that was stopped there. Well, I'm trying to figure this out. I don't want to blow the thing up. Are these mafia guys trying to stop me, or is it just people driving like weirdos? I'm getting some machine gun skill for this, anyway. I'm now a gangsta. I'm hearing police sirens, but I don't seem to have a wanted level. I don't understand what I'm supposed to be doing here. I feel like if I just keep pumping rounds into it, it's gonna blow up. And that is not what we want. Okay. Okay, so these are not mafia guys helping. It's just that everyone's insane. So I gotta drive Johnny back to the meat factory. Is that the hospital, or in the game's being cute, or what? Well, I guess it's not a hospital. A meat wagon is taking meat to, like, dead bodies. Like, that will be called a meat wagon. I don't think you'd call a hospital a meat factory. That doesn't make sense. Okay. It'll be more direct if I can turn around, but it might be safer for me to just go and get off the exit ahead. And shutting off the ambulance noise will make it less irritating for me. Okay, that guy wasn't a mob guy chasing me. He was just being annoying. Either that or he's a mob guy chasing me and he's not really trying that hard. Okay. So like I said, I didn't remember this mission, it was... I enjoyed it, but it wasn't that hard. So that would be about the kind of thing I wouldn't remember years later. One that was kind of fun? Uh-oh. Okay, so these guys are, the enemy. I probably want to just stick with, I was getting a little ahead of myself thinking I was already done. I probably want to stick with, just driving rather than getting out, eliminating them, and carrying on. Because they'll face the same challenge I did, which is they don't want to destroy this vehicle. Or maybe they do. Maybe they don't care. Ultimately, they were going to kill Johnny. I guess they were just taking him somewhere. Why didn't they just go in and kill him, actually? What is the point of taking him out of the hospital? I'm not going to kill him, am I? Oh, that's right, maybe. Am I actually trying to help Ken Rosenberg, or am I just using him for information on how to screw things up? Because ultimately, I don't have the same goals as Ken.
Oh my God, where am I?
Yeah, he's waking up here. Do I get game over if he wakes up, or is it, I'm trying to start a war, because I'm actually trying to mess up with the Italians so that the, triads can take over. Wasn't this place, like, where the enemies hung out?
Hey, Johnny, how you feeling?
I didn't think he was gonna be discharged till tomorrow.
Thanks! unknown guy who drove us here in a shot up ambulance? We didn't drive us here, but I saw some really cool motorcycles. I was hoping more of them would spawn. And they did. Okay. It's gonna shoot the guy up, but easier to just wait for a red light. There's some cool music on Bounce FM, but again, there's a handful of radio stations I really like. Now, here's something we hope you really like that have been fairly kind to me as far as not giving me copyright strikes. SFUR, not my favorite genre of music in the game, and every time we spend any time on that station, it's copyright strike city. Grand Theft Auto, copyright strike city. Let's get some armor. See, Fanny, again, Fanny. So in American slang, Fanny would be the posterior. Most of you guys know this. I don't know that I have a huge audience in the UK. I don't have a huge audience anywhere, really, but
I got everything a real patriot could want.
Okay, so I've already got an M4. I'm just curious what this new, what new thing showed up to buy.
Wise choice.
It might be the M4, actually.
The revolution is coming.
I'm not sure what they consider new, but it's all right. It's all good. But yeah, the fanny mentioned in the lyrics of that song, in the U.S. that means the butt. In the U.K., the fanny is something that a lady would have, and it would be kind of in the front, not the back. So, yeah. I got more missions to do at Caligula's. I can't save at Caligula's, but I can save at the Pirates in Men's Pants. So that would be the place to save. Those are the Clown's Pocket, Royal Casino, Camel's Toe, that's the Pink Swan, the High Roller, Camelot. I don't know if we can go into any of these places, but we can go into this one, and we can. The Camel's Toe and Pirates in Men's Pants and Clown's Pocket are all save points. These other ones, I don't think I can go into Camelot. Har, har, har. I gotta get paid in a hurry, see. I gotta have it if I'm not paid. I start taking. Damn it. If I took damage, it was very little. But it is always a little frustrating to be leaving ammunition where you just spent money to get armor and then take a little tweak so that your health is not maxed out for your next mission. Real niggas with big dicks. I don't know why, but suddenly I want to stop into Binko's and do a little shopping.
Cut the Adam Henry act and we're taking a ride.
Okay. Mid-mission shopping here. Well, it's actually post-mission shopping.
Try on anything you want, sir.
It's the shopping theme from Lufia. Okay. Oh man, they're selling stuff I already got. I know it's a Binko's, but I had this notion that Binko's in different parts of the game would have different stuff, but as you saw, like, there's very... Oh. Maybe I've never bought a... Have I seen this stuff before? Yeah, I did, and I think I didn't care. But there's various, like, silly, goofy stuff I was buying off-camera that I've never shown on-screen, like, you know, cowboy hats and stuff.
These damn hoes bitches can't see me.
You're not actually in Los Santos, so these Santos bitches get, yeah, well, like this, you know. Nobody said it. Nobody has commented on how they want me to stop having CJV Big Boss, though. So I assume everyone's cool with his look. This is not a look I'd ever given him in any previous playthrough of the game.
Have a wonderful day, sir.
Maybe at the end of the game he will change out of the Big Boss costume. We will consider this what he's wearing as he works undercover against Big Smoke. Hey, it's Debo Mendez, at least a guy wearing a striped shirt. Basically, they're the same thing, right? 187 on the cover car. I'm just throwing that phrase out there. I don't know that it has anything to do with the song. Wow, that was a bigger difference in height than I thought these little steps had. Anyway, it's the Pirates in Men's Pants Casino. And it looks like it also could be a really elaborate mini-golf place. Yeah, I can't remember if I've ever played mini-golf. Even as a kid, I don't remember ever having done that. I kind of vaguely pushed for, and by vaguely, I mean really vaguely. I mentioned it as a thing we could do. But when the family was at the Outer Banks one time and there was mini-golf, I was like, hey, does anybody think mini-golf would be fun? And various people were like, oh yeah, like that little six-year-old might like it. I said, we never ended up doing it. Fender Ketchup, explosive situation. You've had your... I've lost track of what was the most recent. Fender Ketchup would have been the most recent. So let's go to... I know Green Goo. We're not going all the way back that far. So I will save there. All right, guys, that's going to be it for this video. And when we come back next time, we will continue doing these missions that relate to Caligula's Casino, because that is how we advance the main story. I'm SiriusJG. Thank you guys very much for watching. And I hope you'll join me next time for more of Grand Theft Auto San Andreas.